As an Australian-Canadian, the Fahrenheit temperature scale has always seemed a bit arbitrary to me. I mean, why does water freeze at 32 degrees? Why that integer? And what exactly does zero represent? According to many sources, the Fahrenheit scale was defined by setting 0 degrees equal to the temperature of an ice, salt, and water mixture, and 100 degrees being roughly equal to human body temperature. But that isn't true. The real story is much more interesting, and scientific. August 14th, 1701 was almost certainly the worst day in the life of 15-year-old Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. On that day, both of his parents died suddenly from mushroom poisoning. And he was sent from Poland, where he lived, to Amsterdam to become an apprentice bookkeeper. But Fahrenheit couldn't stand his apprenticeship and ran away so many times that his employer put out a warrant for his arrest. Traveling from city to city around Europe, he became fascinated with scientific instruments, and in particular, thermometers. In 1708, possibly seeking help with the warrant, Fahrenheit met with the mayor of Copenhagen, who happened to be the famous astronomer Ole Rømer. Rømer is known for observing the eclipses of Jupiter's moons, and realizing that variations in the timing of those eclipses was caused by the time it took light to reach Earth. In other words, he found a way to accurately measure the finite speed of light. But more pertinent to this story, in 1702, Rømer was housebound after breaking his leg, and to pass the time, he devised a brand new temperature scale, with the freezing point of water at 7.5 degrees and body temperature at 22.5 degrees. Now, this might seem odd until you consider that Rømer wanted the boiling point of water to be 60 degrees. As an astronomer, he had experience dividing things by 60. So if you take this scale, divide it in half again, and in half once more, you find the freezing point of water 1/8 up the scale and human body temperature 3/8 up the scale. So at their meeting in 1708, Fahrenheit learned of Rømer's temperature scale and adopted it as his own, adjusting it slightly because he found it inconvenient and inelegant on account of the fractional numbers. So he scaled them up to 8 and 24. And this is the original Fahrenheit scale. He produced thermometers for some time using this scale, but then at some later point, Fahrenheit multiplied all numbers on his scale by 4, setting freezing point to the now familiar 32 and body temperature to 96. It's unclear exactly why he did this. He may just have wanted finer precision in his measurements, but I think there was a better reason. You see, Fahrenheit was an excellent instrument maker. His thermometers agreed with each other precisely at a time when that was unheard of. He pioneered the use of mercury as a measuring liquid, which has the benefit of a much higher boiling point than the alcohol used in most other thermometers at the time. And for these accomplishments, he was inducted into the British Royal Society. And we know that he read the works of Newton, Boyle, and Hooke, in which he would have come across the idea that a 1 degree increase in temperature could correspond to a specific fractional increase in the volume of the measuring liquid. And today, a 1 degree Fahrenheit increase in temperature increases the volume of mercury by exactly 1 part in 10,000. Is this just a coincidence? Well, we'll probably never know for sure because, as an instrument maker, Fahrenheit was very secretive about his methods, but I think the data strongly suggests that this was the case. So what exactly did zero represent on the scales of Fahrenheit and Rømer? By many accounts, it's the temperature of a salt, ice, and water mixture. The only problem is, there are different descriptions of these mixtures, and none of them actually produces the temperature they're supposed to. More likely, I think they picked the coldest temperature in winter, set that as zero, and later used ice and brine to calibrate new thermometers. In his day, the Fahrenheit thermometer was the best you could get, but now his scale is only used regularly in the Cayman Islands, Bahamas, Belize, oh, and the United States of America. So maybe it's time we all adopted the global scale of temperature, Celsius, which, by the way, wasn't invented by Celsius at all.
Hey, so that was something a little bit different. This video was animated by Marcelo Ascani. I've got a link to his channel in the description. You know, I became really fascinated with temperature scales after I saw the original Celsius thermometer. You can see that video here. Now, this video was supported in part by viewers like you on Patreon and by Audible.com, a leading provider of audiobooks with hundreds of thousands of titles in all areas of literature, including fiction, nonfiction, and periodicals. And for viewers of this channel, Audible offers a free 30-day trial where you can download any book of your choosing. Just go to audible.com/veritasium. And I have a book that I would recommend to you. It is called The Structure of Scientific Revolutions by Thomas S. Kuhn. This is a classic in the history and philosophy of science, and it'll make you see science in a different way because it shows us that science is not just one process, but there are actually revolutions that take place when big discoveries are made. And that really changed my thinking about science when I first read this book 10 years ago. So you can check it out by going to audible.com/veritasium, download it for free, and try out the Audible service. So I want to thank Audible for supporting me, and I want to thank you for watching.